Thank you. It is indeed right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole world is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals a judgment that has come upon the world.
Tuesday the 6th of August, weather fine, my birthday, 21 and feel
1940, Tuesday the 8th of October,
high seas washing over boat, 10:05 bombarded by plane,
engines broken down, 6 dead,
1941, Wednesday the 5th of March, up at 5:30, off at 7:15, did 120 miles, very uninteresting, arrived new camp,
1941,
Thursday the 20th of March, no mail for me, very disappointed, felt
1941,
dying. Monday the 14th of April, air raids all day, dive bomb, hit town, very hit town.
Mr. Pickwick paused, considered, pulled off his gloves and put them in his hat, took two or three short runs, balked himself as often, and at last took another run and went slowly and gravely down the slide, with his feet about a yard and a quarter apart, amidst the gratified shouts of all the spectators. The sport was at its height, the sliding was at its quickest, the laughter was at its loudest, when a sharp, smart crack was heard. There was a quick rush towards the bank, a wild scream from the lady. A large mass of ice disappeared, the water bubbled over it, and Mr. Pickwick's hat, gloves and handkerchief were floating on the surface. It was all of Mr. Pickwick that anybody could see. Pain and anguish were depicted on every countenance. The males turned pale, the females fainted. Mr. Snodgrass and Mr. Winkle grasped each other by the hand and gazed at the spot. Their leader had gone down with frenzied eagerness, while Mr. Tupman assistance, and at the same time conveying to any persons who might be within hearing the clearest possible notion of the catastrophe, ran off across most speed, screaming, "Fire!" with all his might and main.
Good King Wenceslas looked out on the feast of Stephen, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even. Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel, when a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel. Hear the page and stand by me, if thou knowest it telling. Yonder peasant, who is he? Where and what is dwelling? Sire, he lives a good league hence, underneath the mountain, right against the forest fence, by St. Agnes Fountain. Bring me flesh and bring me wine, bring me pine logs hither. Thou and I will see him dine when we bear them thither. Page and monarch forth they went together, through the rude wind's wild lament and the bitter weather. Sire, the night is darker now, and the wind blows stronger. Fails my heart, I know not how, I can go no longer. Mark my footsteps, good my page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou shalt find the winter's rage freeze thy blood less cold.
A fish, can they say? Yee? Yow, 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 who is a guy? Yow, don't go yee, who is see? Yow, yow, ding. An English fish is, well, just fish. We all like to eat with, but Chinese, you got meaning of fish. That's one thing. And, yeah, another thing is here. What the hell?
If all the dreams within my heart could e'er come true, I would not wish them for myself, but all for you. So having life at your command, with power to bless, you'd bring to me with loving hand your happiness.
I only desire, my dearest Emma, that you will always believe that Nelson's your own. Nelson's Alpha and Omega is Emma. I cannot alter. My affection and love is beyond even this world. Nothing can shake it but yourself. And that I will not allow myself to think for a moment is possible. I feel that you are the real friend of my bosom, and dearer to me than life. And that I am the same to you. Ever, forever, I am yours, only yours, even beyond this world.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.